As I promised in my last video, in today's video, I'm going to be doing a deep dive into Kadena. And at the end of the video, some price predictions and models. They are pretty crazy. So make sure you stick around until the end. And just for total transparency, right up front, I do own Kadena. Now, before we rock and roll today, if you're new to the channel, the goal here is financial freedom earlier in life, where I cover anything and everything to get us there faster. Right now, crypto has the best alpha, and so that's what I've been talking about most on the channel recently. Now, real quick, hit that subscribe button for me, hit that like button, and share this video on social media, and find me on Twitter at Joshua Makos. Remember, too, I was talking about Kadena when it was still $6, so you just might want to subscribe so that you don't miss out on other gems that I talk about here on this channel. So make sure you hit that subscribe button for me, and let's get going. Real quick, as always, this video is not financial advice. This is not investment advice. This is all educational entertainment. As always, do your own research and invest at your own risk. Now let's get into the actual meat and potatoes here today. First up, what is Kadena? It is a layer one blockchain built for speed, decentralization, scale, and security. Its primary function is to enable smart contracts and dApps. Kadena's primary competitors are Ethereum, Solana, Cardano, Phantom, basically any and all of the other smart contract layer ones out there. What sets Kadena apart from many of the other layer ones, though, is that they intend to stay proof of work, and almost every other SCP layer one out there is or intends to move to proof of stake. You can argue which way is better until you're blue in the face, but that's not what this video is about. Now, Kadena makes some of the following claims. First up is that they have a safer smart contract using their PACT smart contract coding language. PACT makes designing safer smart contracts effortless, whether you're writing your first contract or launching your 50th dApp. By automatically detecting bugs, PACT frees you from the exploits you'll face on Ethereum or other unsafe platforms. Their second claim is that they have virtually no cost transactions. Kadena offers marginal transaction fees for consumers, and they've gone a step further in introducing the first crypto gas station to allow businesses or dApps or smart contracts to eliminate all transaction fees for their customers by removing a key barrier to mass adoption. This makes it that much more attractive for businesses or dApps or developers to actually develop on Kadena. Their third claim, it's energy efficient at scale. As network demand increases, Kadena's energy use is designed to remain constant. Its unique architecture supposedly makes it the only platform that can deliver increased energy efficiency as the network scales up. So it's not you need more energy to get more scale. They're claiming that it's all equal. The fourth out of five claims is it's proven security. Kadena runs on proof of work, like I said before, which is reliable, secure, and battle hardened. The most secure network in the world uses proof of work, and that's Bitcoin. So it has a pretty good track record. Kadena's last claim to fame is their industrial scalability. Kadena claims to be designed to power global financial systems like the NASDAQ or the NYSE or stock trading or equities trading or anything like that that needs massive transactions per second and extreme security. Their protocol continually scales higher transaction to higher transactions per second as more chains are added to the network. And they've already done this once before, going from 10 to 20 chains, which they're currently operating at now. So they've proven they can handle scaling an active network, a network that's currently doing stuff. They're able to actually scale it, and they've shown that in the past. All that explains what Kadena is, but what makes Kadena special? What sets it apart from all the other smart contracts out there? Number one is their scaling mechanism. Kadena was designed to scale by braiding together multiple chains. This is very, very different from sharding, which has a very different mechanism. Braiding chains together requires that every chain talks to at least X number of other chains, depending on how the braiding structure is set up. In the case of Kadena, each separate chain must communicate and mine three other chains. And by braiding together the network of 10 or 20 or 100 chains, each verifying the work of three other chains, it essentially keeps every other chain honest without needing to have to mine all 10 or 20 or 100 chains, which would ultimately just slow down the network. Having to mine three chains keeps mining fast and the network scalable, and also by braiding chains together and mining them simultaneously, it makes the network more secure because it makes it much more difficult to be able to attack a particular chain because there are multiple chains all validating each other at the same time. So it was originally the whole braiding scheme was designed for security, but it has been applied to scale for Kadena. Now, moving tokens between chains utilizes a simple payment verification smart contract. In terms of user experience, though, I hope the wallets that come out for Kadena just handle this in the background. But I'll touch more on this later because it's kind of a drawback, and we're going to get to those later in this video. The other big differentiator for Kadena is Pact, their smart contract language. Pact brings smart contracts to a whole new level in crypto. It allows for contracts to be easily updated and upgraded over time with an approval process that can be built into it beforehand. So you can design your smart contract to be multi-sig, have them be approvers and all of that. And it can actually be designed to be upgraded over time as you find bugs, as you develop things, as you introduce new things to your smart contract. And so you don't have to launch new contracts to be able to handle different things. So I think it's a great idea that they've allowed for this to happen, and they've designed Kadena to be able to handle such a thing. It is also designed, Pact is made much easier to code with all your smart contracts. Supposedly, that's what they say. It's supposed to be much easier. It's supposed to be human readable code. So I'll have to take it. I'm not a developer, so I'll just take them at that word. And it is also designed to have governance easily built into the contract upon initial setup. So you really don't even have to build a smart contract, have it launch, and then you have to build a DAO. Outside of that, you can build your DAO into your smart contract, and it has governance already built into it and everything taken care of all in one nice, neat package. And when you make things simpler, that makes developers more eager to be able to develop on it because it makes their life easier. The third special trait of Kadena is the TPS and block time, 480,000 transactions per second and 1.5 seconds per block. So it's very fast and it's very scalable. Last but not least, the blockchain itself. But don't go anywhere just yet. We're going to get to those juicy price predictions that I mentioned at the beginning of the video. So stick with me through to the end and we're going to get to those. So Kadena was originally designed in such a way to address many problems current blockchains struggle with today. And I am only just scratching the surface here, so you're going to want to go research this yourself. But one unique feature of Kadena is that NFT files can be stored digitally within the blockchain itself. Unlike all the other blockchains that usually utilize Filecoin servers to house the more than 7 million NFT files in existence, this feature may seem small, but it simplifies the overall smart contract development with not having to go to Filecoin or find storage service for your NFTs or your other things that your smart contract might need. That they're able to code it into and digitally embed it into the blockchain is pretty damn cool. And what makes life easier for devs makes it more likely to develop on the platform in the future. So I think it's pretty cool, but hey, go research for yourself. Now, all right, I talked about a bunch of the special features Kadena offers, but what about the negatives? There's always negatives, and I'm going to talk about a few of them. So it's not all sunshine and rainbows for Kadena, so let's get into those. Number one is the tokenomics right now are interesting and somewhat convoluted and hard to understand. Kadena has a fixed token supply, 1 billion tokens, so it's very different than a lot of other smart contracts out there which have an unlimited supply and inflation built into it. Kadena has a locked supply. 70% will be mined by miners over the next 100 plus years. 20% are platform tokens. We'll get into what those are. 6% was allocated to early investors, angel investors, such as the such. 3% was given to contributors, so people on the actual Kadena team. Makes them more likely to be invested in the project themselves when they have a personal stake in it. And 1% was burned. So 70% is pretty straightforward. Very similar to how Bitcoin rewards miners for mining new blocks. This is what that 70% or 700 million tokens are set aside for. These will be mining rewards distributed over the next 100 years. Now, the questionable part that a lot of people really are a little uneasy about is the 20% of the platform tokens are, it's somewhat confusing. These are essentially Kadena Foundation tokens to be used on a set schedule to help boost or promote Kadena in the early years of its existence. So Kadena uses the platform tokens for grants, strategic partnerships, pretty much anything to help grow Kadena's network. Solana does the exact same thing with their foundation tokens. This 20% that Kadena has set aside has a set max amount that they can distribute per month to also prevent dumping the supply and tanking the price. The rest of the allocations are pretty straightforward. The major drawback to me, though, the negative about Kadena is that Kadena reserves the right to change the platform token distribution schedule however they see fit. But since they themselves are token holders as contributors, that 3%, they have an economic incentive to not screw over the price of Kadena. So they are economically incentivized to keep Kadena's price up. It impacts them financially. So I'm not too concerned about the overall tokenomics here. The second big drawback of four I'm going to talk about here today is it's a brand new chain and it has very few devs building on it. The ecosystem is lacking. It's pretty much non-existent, but this is also why the price is so low. It's why it's not 30 to 50 to $100 billion. If it had a market cap like Cardano and no dApps like Cardano, I'd be a lot more concerned about buying into it. But since it's new, not many people are talking about it just yet. I think that their ecosystem growth will come with time, and getting in early now is risky, but with more risk, there is reward. So I see it as a possible upside that they don't really have a big ecosystem yet because that's a lot of room for growth. The third big drawback that I kind of alluded to before is their wallets. Their two main wallets that they currently offer are not user-friendly at all to the average Joe. I'm not a fan of Zelcore, their main wallet that they offer to most people, and their Chainweaver wallet is more for developers. And their wallets make moving between chains a pain because if you have a wallet on one chain, you have to transfer it to another chain. You need to transfer across chains. And so that's a step in between doing everything. And if a dApp is built on chain 5 and you're on chain 1, you have to go over to chain 5 to be able to interact with it. So I don't really like that. I think that future wallets, and this is what I hope, become much more user-friendly and take care of all of the cross-chain transferring and doing all that stuff in the background, so I don't even have to deal with it. That if I have my Kadena on chain 1, I need to interact with the dApp on chain 5. It just does that automatically in the background and I don't even have to worry about it. So that's my hope for their wallets, but currently that's not how it runs. The final drawback, but also the greatest opportunity for Kadena, is that they are not on any major exchanges yet. And in my opinion, when they get on Coinbase or Binance or any of the other big exchanges, the price of Kadena could appreciate quite a bit, and that's what I'm looking forward to. All right, so I've talked about what Kadena is, I've talked about what makes Kadena special, I've talked about the negative aspects of Kadena. Now let's talk about money, the price predictions that I talked about at the beginning of this video. And at the time of recording this video, Kadena is sitting at around 20 bucks and a $3 billion market cap. So it's pretty healthy, it's got a pretty healthy market cap, but is there room for growth? That's the question we have, and how far could it grow? Now, this might sound crazy, but I think that comparing Kadena to Cardano is a decent model to work off of. Cardano doesn't really have any major dApps built on it just yet, and it has a $70 billion market cap. It's fluctuating up and around, but it has about a $70 billion market cap. And if Kadena does everything right and starts to really expand their ecosystem, then I think Kadena could go to a $30 to $50 billion market cap in the future. This could put the price per token for Kadena at $200 to $300 US dollars. That's crazy seeing that we're at $20 right now. For the end of 2021 though, I would put my price target for Kadena at $100, which I think is pretty conservative and very, very possible for them to be able to pull off unless something very, very bad happens. And again, this is not financial advice. This is not investment advice. Always do your own research. Kadena could easily flop for all I know and go to zero tomorrow. So always do your own research and invest at your own risk. All right, guys and gals, let me know what you think of Kadena down in the comment section below. I know there's a lot of technical aspects I didn't dive super deep into in this video, so I highly recommend you go to their website, read their white paper, and see for yourself. Always do your own research. I just said it. Make sure you like this video. I appreciate it. Supports the channel and helps this video get out in front of more people. Make sure you subscribe to not miss out on future videos. And remember, I was talking about Kadena when it was 6 bucks, and it's at 20 bucks right now. That's almost a 4x in just a week. So you might find a few more gems by subscribing here to this channel. Let's go make some money. Guys and gals, I'll see you out there.